I'm going to a music special, and can't you tell that I feel swell? I'm gonna clap along and sing my favorite song and all the listen music special.
Hello everybody, welcome back. This is lesson number 20 of our music special class this year. We're going to learn about repeat signs in music. We're going to learn about the trumpet, and we'll play a game of guess what instrument as well. If we have time, we'll also slip in a game of high or low at the end of today's class. So let's get started.
Guess what? Guess what? Guess what instrument? Guess what? Guess what? Guess what instrument is making that sound?
You see conga drums, a saxophone, and an electric bass on your screen. Listen. Saxophone. You see a piano, a recorder, and a timpani on your screen. Listen. Was a timpani. You see a tuba, a bassoon, and an oboe on your screen. Listen. That was a tuba.
What instrument is that? What instrument is that? How does it sound? Where is it found? But first of all, you must tell me now, what instrument is that?
The trumpet. The trumpet is one of the oldest instruments, dating to before 1500 BCE. The modern trumpet is constructed of brass, having either three piston valves or, less commonly, rotary valves. The smallest trumpets, with the highest pitches, are called piccolo trumpets. Trumpets are used in jazz bands, military bands, marching bands, ethnic bands, orchestras, and wind ensembles. So, being one of the oldest instruments from 1500 BCE, let's see here, it's about 2000 right now. I'm just going to use approximate dates. So going back to zero, that would be 2000 years. And then going further back another 1500 years, the trumpet is about 3,500 years old. That's quite old. We learned that it has three piston valves or rotary valves. To us, it doesn't really matter the difference right now. The valves are the buttons on the trumpet, which of course we press on in different ways to create different combinations to make different sounds. We learned that the smallest trumpets are called piccolo trumpets. We know that there's another instrument called a piccolo, which is a very, very small flute and has a high, piercing tone to it. We also learned that trumpets can be used in many different types of musical situations, and they are. What we're going to watch right now is the opening of a very powerful piece of music by Mahler. It's his fifth symphony. And the trumpet is the instrument that features most in this very first segment of the composition. So let's watch. Let's talk about repeat signs. These are quite common in music. You'll see a lot of them in our music books. So two dots placed before the double bar indicates a repeat sign. You see that in the first example. The double bar, by the way, is what comes at the very end of a song. The repeat sign means to go back to the beginning and play or sing the whole thing again. So let me play this first example for you. One, two, one, two. So if you were following along, you saw that I played that twice. I repeated it and played it through entirely twice. Sometimes repeat signs appear in pairs within a piece of music, as in the second example that you see. The first repeat sign will then have the two dots placed after the double bar. When this occurs, return to the first repeat sign at the beginning of the section. So if you look at that second piece of music, it starts with two half notes, which are C's. And then we get into this part of the music, which is surrounded with these repeat signs. That means that when we repeat this time, we're not going to go all the way back to the beginning. We're just going to go back to that first set of repeat signs, which are faced towards the right, you might say. They're after the double bar. So let me play the second example. You follow along. One, two, one, two. Okay, good. Let's look at the third example. Another way of indicating a repeat is with first and second endings. Players sing through the first ending to the repeat sign, then go back to the beginning. When repeating, skip the first ending and play the second. Okay, so this one's in 4/4 time, as you see. We're going to, on the first time that I play it, we're going to hear me play that bit underneath the bracket with the number one. And then we'll go back to the beginning. And when we play through it the second time, I'm going to skip that part that's underneath the bracket which says number one. And I'm going to skip over it to the part that says number two. And I'll play that as the ending. So let's listen. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Skipping. Skipping. Okay, those are repeat signs, first and second endings. Thanks for paying attention. Okay, everybody, welcome back to High or Low. It's been quite a while since we've played. Here's note number one. Note number two. Note number two was lower. Kind of a weird sound there. It's called atmosphere. How about this? Note number one. Note number two. Note number two was higher. This one is called Goblins. Note number one. Note number two. Note number two was lower. Note number one. Note number two. Note number two was higher. Let's play just one more time. Note number one. Note number two. Note number two was lower. Okay, thank you for playing.
Well, thank you again for coming to music class. I appreciate your attention to it, and I will see you next time. Bye.
I'm going to music special, and can't you tell that I feel swell? I'm gonna clap along and sing.